Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild. In this video, we are going to cover how to analyze transactions using the accounting equation. The accounting equation is assets equals liabilities plus equity. This rule applies to every single transaction a company makes. So after each transaction, assets must always equal liabilities plus equity. If they don't, we have a problem. Also, the equity part of the accounting equation can be expanded. The expanded accounting equation is assets equal liabilities plus common stock minus dividends plus revenues and minus expenses. I know that sounds like a lot, but I think it will make more sense as we go through some transactions. For example, let's assume a business is just starting out and the owner invests $50,000 cash in the business. Analyzing this transaction using the accounting equation, we see that assets increased $50,000 because of the increase in cash, and equity increases $50,000 because of the increase in common stock. After the investment, the first order of business is to purchase supplies. In our case, the business purchases $5,000 of supplies on credit. This means that the supplies are received right now, but we will pay for them later. Using the accounting equation, we increase assets by $5,000 under supplies and increase liabilities under accounts payable for $5,000. After that, the business needs equipment. So the business purchases equipment for $12,000 cash. Using the accounting equation, we decrease cash by $12,000 and increase equipment by $12,000. This is an exchange of one asset for another and does not change the dollar amount of total assets. Now that we have supplies and equipment, we're open for business. So we provide advisory services to a customer and send them a bill for $8,000. Yeah, our advice is just that great. Because we didn't receive cash right after providing the services, this creates an accounts receivable, meaning the customer owes us money. So to analyze this transaction, we increase assets by $8,000 under accounts receivable and increase equity by $8,000 under revenues. Several weeks later, when the customer pays us back for the $8,000 worth of services, we increase cash for $8,000 and decrease accounts receivable for $8,000. Again, we see that the repayment does not change the total amount of assets and does not affect liabilities or equity. It converts one asset, the receivable, to another asset, cash. Being repaid does not create any new revenue. Next, we have to pay our employee wages of $4,500. Using the accounting equation, we decrease assets under cash for $4,500 and decrease equity under expenses for $4,500. Now we also have to pay cash for the supplies we purchased earlier on credit. If you remember, we initially recorded an accounts payable for the transaction. Instead of paying the full amount now, we will make a partial payment of $3,000. To account for this, we decrease assets by $3,000 and decrease liabilities under accounts payable for $3,000. I know this can be tricky, but this payment does not create an expense even though cash flows out of the business. Instead, the expense will be recorded after we actually use the supplies. Last, we want to take $500 cash out of the business for personal use. We're going on spring break. Using the accounting equation, we decrease assets by $500 and decrease equity by $500. Under equity, this decrease is recorded in dividends, which are not expenses because they do not help earn revenue.